My name is Pieter van der Heijden from Amsterdam, the Netherlands. I am your facilitator this evening, consultant volunteer at ZAPLAB Suriname. I will not spend time to explain where the country of Suriname is situated. And I chair the working group FabLabs and Sustainable Development Goals. This is a 45-minute online workshop for teachers and managers of a FabLab. We communicate in English, but the tool we use is also available in French, Spanish, Portuguese, Brazil, and Dutch. And if you lose contact during the workshop, you have to go to one special page. I will show that as well in the chat. I will write the link in the chat. So that is the central point where you have to be if you got lost, and you can have an eye on it while we are busy, and it brings you to the tool, it brings you to the worksheets, etc. One moment, please. That is bit.ly/FES-SDGS. Do you see the link? If you press that link, you come on a special landing page for this workshop, which gives you access to the tools we need during the workshop, but also to a lot of extra interesting links. But you can explore the links later after the workshop. This page remains available for you. If you remember the link or write down the link, then you can always come back. I will share now my screen. That is always, and I will share with, yes. Okay. And do you see the mind map now?
Yes.
Big mind map on your screen. So, okay. Well, welcome. I have shared my screen now, and you can see the webpage for the workshop. There are two important components here. The tool we are using in 5 different languages. If you have it on your own screen, you can click on the link, and then you see a special panel where you can select the language, and then you go to the tool. And the tool looks, I have opened it already here, the tool looks in this way. So I go back to this screen, and later we need a worksheet. And there is a special link there, and we are not so many people, so we only need the first link, the intake one, later. And if you do that, you come to a page with an attendance list, etc. But I will go through it in a minute. Any questions so far? No questions? Okay, then I will ask you now, go to the worksheets. Then you enter there the first tab, the attendance list. You find an empty line and you enter your personal details there. We are interested in your first name, your last name, the name of your lab, the country where you live, and your email address. Maybe you don't want to share some of this information, then send me an email directly. And you see here my email address. I will write it in the chat as well, if I can manage to see the chat box now while I am in the screen sharing mode. Well, that I do that later. My email address, you can send me directly. Then I send you the report afterwards. I hope that we can collect a lot of material today and that I can send you an interesting report afterwards. Check what you have entered. Remember your sequence number, because you need that later. So if you do that, you go to this page. I see it here. Okay, there are already a number of names filled in. That goes well. We are with about six people, more or less. So I think we are on time. That is great, great, great. Then I can continue with the next task. It's already evening here, so. Okay, I go back to, that is always handy. I go back to the mind map. This one, I make it a little bit more readable. Okay. We are now talking about the 17 SDGs, and we are going to select your favorite one. there's a picture there, and the picture is also behind me. I think you know it. You can make that panel a little bit broader so that you can read it better. All 193 member states of the United Nations agree to the report Transforming Our World, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. This Agenda 2030 describes the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, but also 169 underlying sub-goals. They called them in English the targets. And all countries of the world agreed with this agenda, and implementation is in their hands. So the individual countries have the responsibility to try to realize this very ambitious agenda for all countries in the world, not only for the poor countries, not only for the developing countries, all countries. They need to realize that preferably in 2030. All over the world, all kinds of programs and projects are now underway, and they have to report every 2 years, etc., etc. And all institutes and social organizations, the civil society, companies, every instance, every organization has to be involved sooner or later. So therefore it is interesting and important for FabLabs too, but we also think it is important for the external orientation and the social impact of the FabLabs to incorporate the sustainable development goals and the plans incorporated in it in your activities. Now, for tonight, we especially focus on training, education, learning activities in the FabLab. Okay, I go to the details, and I ask you now to visit the tool in the language of your choice. And I have opened the tool here already in English. Go through the 17 goals and choose one goal for which you want to design a learning activity. Write down or remember that number because you need it later. So look at the tool and how you use this tool. I will tell you later, but for the moment you only have to read through these 17 icons. And if you see interesting icons, you can also read the sentence below, the subtitle, which is more elaborated, more or less. And later we will also look at the targets, at the sub-goals. So pick one for yourself, and that is the one you are going to develop a learning activity for. Any questions so far? No questions, that is good. I hope you have found your favorite. And the motive you could have to select one, that could be very, very different. For the moment, for this evening, it is nice if the 6-7 people have all different topics chosen. But And there are already more than 300 fab labs that have prepared a profile for themselves, for their external activities, a profile of 4 SDGs. And these are quite different. There's a great variety, although I must admit that almost 80%, 80% of the fab labs has number 4 in its profile. Okay, so far so good. I return to my landing page and see what I should do next. Zoom in on one of the targets. Okay, I have to explain to you how you should do that. Suppose you have selected, let's say, number 11. Sustainable cities and environments. Then you click on the tiny icon, the tiny circle to the right of this symbol. And immediately you see all the targets that belong to goal number 11. So sustainable cities and communities is number L11. And 11 has been subdivided in 11.1, 11.2, etc., and later A, B, and C. If you cannot read it, it is perfectly zoomable. So nobody, you see. And what you have to do now is, take your preferred goal and open the targets of the goal in this tool and find a target for which you want to develop your learning activity. So be more specific and have a very quick read of the about 10 targets for every goal and pick one. And remember that number or letter. We need it later. There is much more possible with this tool. What is especially interesting, I think, is that there is a search function. For the moment, that goes too far, but in the bottom, you see a search field where you can look for instance, if I close this one, and I look for whatever topic like youth or girls or disasters. As soon as I choose for disaster, I even do not have to type the whole word. I see there are six places in all these goals and targets where disasters are mentioned. So if your typical field of interest is disaster risk reduction, etc., then you can walk through the goals, number 1, number 2, number 11, 11 again, and number 13. By the way, the whole climate Paris, the Paris Agreement on climate change is incorporated in the goals as well. And so you can browse through them. Okay, for the moment, that is enough. I hope you all have found your favorite target to work on and to prepare a learning activity for. I go back to my original map. Look at the instructions. You stay in the tool that you had opened already. You go to the goal you selected earlier. You open the sub-goals. Go through the sub-goals, choose one which you want to for which you want to design a learning activity. Write down the number, for instance, 11 point B or whatever. Also write down some keywords to describe the topic of your learning activity to be developed. Okay. Then we go to the next part of the workshop, okay, we are going to describe a learning activity. How are we going to do that? Well, there is a picture over there. I hope you can see that on my screen, or you can open it in the, if you click here in your landing page, then you see that same picture, the learning activity specification. In fact, I need more space, I see. Okay, there it is. I have some metadata. I have the real activity plan for the activity. What are the inputs? What are the process steps? And what are the expected outputs? And how you are going to review the results of your participants, students, pupils, or how you want to call them. Please. Later on, I will extend these slides with some more text. So we now come to the devising and specifying the learning activity that matches your selected SDG goal and the sub-goal. Due to the time, everyone does this individually using an online form in our worksheets. So we first ask you to indicate some characteristics of your learning activity, then to describe the learning activity itself, the inputs, the steps, and the outputs, and finally, how you want to test the results, the review. Your answers together form a very first draft for the specification of your learning activity. So I ask you to keep up the pace and try to provide all questions on our form with a provisional answer. So rather a provisional answer, which you can always change and improve later, than no answer at all. Are there any questions at this moment? Okay, then I close this. I go to the back to the agenda. I open this, and we have to go now to the worksheets. So go here to the worksheets for the participants and select intake one. That is the document where you have filled in your attendance list. We go back to that document. And I show it for you here. Here it is. Suppose I am Mr. Tom, the first one on the list. Then I go to the bottom and I click on number one. And Olivia clicks on tab number two. And André on number three, etc. So let's take Tom as an example. I click on Tom and then I see Tom's name and his lab in the red field already filled in. So don't change the red fields. You only may write whatever you want in the green fields. So here, Tom can answer, it can give a title for his learning activity. And in the next one, I have written there 11B for everybody, but that is just to check the mechanism. You can write here the goal point, sub-goal. So if you have goal 3, sub-goal 4, you write here 3.4. And then the text in red is filled in automatically. So there are a lot of fields and some red fields. And please don't change the spreadsheet itself. Then we will run into troubles. Only use the green fields to add your answers. I will walk through them very quietly so that we can fill in this all together. So I leave the document for Tom, and I look in the attendance list if there is an empty one. Oh yeah, number four is empty. So I go and look at number four. I show you what, I will present it and talk you through this document. So what we are going to do now is, in fact, filling in this form and coming with a first very rough description of a learning activity. And the learning activity is related with the SDGs, of course. Please only fill the green fields and leave the other fields what they are. Okay, I will tell you very in a slow time what you should fill in, what the meaning is, and you at the same time can try to do that for your own form. So at the top, you will see that your name, FabLab, and country already have been filled in. That is simply copied from the attendance sheet. Then you have here to invent a title for your learning activity in a few words. That is how it can be found later. Suppose you finish it as a regular learning activity, what should be the title to find it back? And we add the SDG code automatically. And so here you type the title. Then here you type the SDG code. For instance, if that is 3.4 for me, then you see what happens. And I automatically see the English text for the goals and for the sub-goal. And we could have made that for other languages as well. That is a great thing that in all these countries, the whether you work in Chinese and don't speak Chinese, or whether you work with Arabic friends and don't speak and read Arabic, the numbers are the same. So you can always communicate via the number language about the SDGs you are interested in. Okay, then in row number 8, I have to fill in a few keywords. The keywords you have written down earlier. Well, these are the tags also to find your learning activity back, a few words that describe the learning activity. The next row, number 9, describes the age group for which you are defining an activity. Simply select one you feel most comfortable with, or you have a nice idea in your mind, then you write it down and we go on. The next one is to list the hardware, for instance, the fab machines or other tools, the software, and maybe some external services like the internet or maybe your Google Drive or whatever that are indispensable for this activity. Of course, you don't have to write down every piece of paper, but the main things that are normally abundant and available in an activity setting, so that you know that you can reserve them in advance. Then we are interested in the learning objective. You only have to write one word. Is it about knowledge transfer? Do you want that they acquire some skills or some experience or have some experience? Or are you busy with their attitude toward a certain topic? Simply choose one of these three. Online 12. What are you going to use as a teaching mode, as didactic mode? Are the students working individually? They're doing this activity on their own, maybe even as homework or in the classroom on their own, or in pairs or in groups, or is it a plenary activity? Just write it down. And then the time in minutes, to test the spreadsheet. I see I have written 45 in every spreadsheet, but you can choose your own time. Eh? What is the time you need, you have in mind for your classroom activity? Maybe it is shorter, maybe it's longer. Then there are a few fields which will be filled automatically. Don't care about it and don't touch them. And then comes the most important part. And there I leave you alone for a couple of minutes. Which information are you going to provide to your students? That are the inputs for the learning activities. Then, what steps do you ask your students to go through? And there you can, with Alt Enter, you can go to a new line, as you see here. And you can write a few steps that they have to fulfill. I go back to let you see where we are. So. In this way. And ultimately, what outputs do you require from your students? Should they really make something physically, some prototype or a presentation or a publication or a little bit documentation? I see the word prototype is not mentioned here, but that is also an option, of course, certainly in a fab lab, and that you can describe here. So this is in fact the most important part of the learning activity that shows what you are going to offer to your students. So please spend some time here to inputs, process and outputs. And then the last thing we need to know is how will you test that your intended learning objective has been met? I see this, okay, maybe you need a short trick and say format. I cannot format this. No, okay, you find a solution. If the field is too small, it should be possible to make it broader. If not, simply type. I will fix that later. Okay, is that enough? Other questions? Can you fill in the form? I'm very curious to see what you will produce ultimately.
Peter, I have a question. This is Olivia from Greece.
Hi.
Hi. I missed the part where you explained their learning objective. That's in row 11.
Yeah.
Could you please repeat that?
Yeah, we can spend a lot of time to it, but I used, in fact, a shortcut to simply say, is it knowledge, is it experience, or is it attitude? What is the main goal of this activity? Should they become handy in dealing with some concepts, the difficult words mentioned in the target, for instance, or should they practice something? What is the difference between a little experiment with solar energy and wind energy, for instance? You can have your tools or some stuff to do that. Or should it be more about attitude? Is it more in the field of a role playing and discuss with other people in other roles, for instance, about some topics? Is that enough?
Yeah, that's very clear. Yes, that's okay. Great. Thank you.
Any other questions? I see yeah, you all have at least filled in a little bit, but I see the goal and the goal has not been filled in, the SDG code and the sub code, the goal and the target.
Sorry, Peter, one question. Sorry, I am a little bit lost. I have hear you. Could you do a resume of the past, the steps that we have to do? So I think first...
What is your What is your sequence number on the attendance list?
Yes, I think it's the 11.
Number 11. Then I go to your form. What we are doing now, or your name is not on the, is your name not on the list?
No. Sorry, I'm not in the list. Sorry, I have to do that.
Okay. In the attendance list, you can fill in your name. Eh? And then here you, if that is still number 11, here you can fill in your activity. So we start in line 4 with a title for the activity. And what did you select, a goal or a sub-goal? One of the 17. Which one did you select?
Okay.
Perfect. So here... Yeah. So suppose you have 1.1.
Yes.
And that is end poverty in all its forms everywhere. And the sub-goal is eradicate extreme poverty for all people everywhere, currently measured as people living on less than $1.25 a day. And I can invent all kind of learning activity for such a sub-goal, for instance. But you can take whatever you like, and then you continue with some tags to describe this, the age group.
Okay.
This is enough.
Okay.
You can go.
Yes. One last question: the sheet, worksheet for the participants.
Attendance.
I'm looking for. Ah, perfect. I am there. Okay. I am well. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Any other questions?
And we have about 13 minutes.
Yeah.
Just remember.
So I hope I see some people have written down information on it could also be that my overview is a little bit delayed because of the heavy use that I don't see immediately what the results are. But anyway, I go slowly to the next step to be in time with the full exercise. So I go back to my landing page. I can show you a table with the results. So I'm going to present what you have filled in on your forms. in the overview table, you can check what you have filled in yourself, and we can have a look together there. So I open it now in the shared screen here. You can go to the hamburger menu, the menu here, and you can click on summary. That brings you to the overview sheet. Let's see whether I can There is something, a problem with the formatting. You should see that more. It should be broader so that you could see more lines at the same time. But I will fix that later. That takes now too much time. Anyway, we see here the different goals. We see 11.7, 3.4, 4.7, 12.5, 9.1, etc. We see also some titles, the Healthy Habit Calendar, the Creative Factory, Giving a Lamp, as a and something more. The Fusion of Soft Skills, Healthy Logo, How to Make it Circular. We see the age groups, and in fact, the other metadata are hidden for whatever reason. After the session, I will immediately repair this so that you can see it today in the right way. But I sent you a report later by email where I have cleaned up whatever has to be cleaned. Okay, and then we see here. Inputs, the process, and the outputs. There is a short beginning of descriptions. And we see here only the first three words, but I'm sure that there is more. If we can extend the width, the height of the cells. Okay, so you can look at people who have used the same goal and the same target as you, see what you can learn from them. You can also look, if you have the full information, at the country of the other people and see what the people in your own country, if you are with more people from the same country, what they have produced. That could be interesting because you speak the same local language, so you could work together to produce interesting learning activities around the SDGs in your own local language. Developing such a learning activity could be quite time-consuming, so it is a good way to share with each other and to help each other use, again, the materials that have been developed by other people. Okay, any comments so far or any questions? It is a rush, I realize, and it is always a surprise with the technology, but it gives you at least a first idea and where you can work further. Okay, I go to the last part of the presentation, the last 5 minutes, back to my landing page, number 6, the evaluation and the checkout. Oh, we have there an interesting picture. For instance, a lot of Fab Labs have prepared their SDG profile, the four SDGs that describe their interest. And here you see the Fab Labs in Africa with an SDG profile. And at least all the Fab Labs that have number 4 in the profile. The other ones I omitted for the moment, but to give you an impression, and you can do that for your own Fab Lab as well. What I want to tell you more, that is that on my landing page, there is a lot more information. The working group that has prepared this session, the working group on Fab Labs and SDGs, has interesting materials you can find here. But there are also a lot of references on schools, Fab Labs, makerspaces, and the SDGs. For instance, Train the Trainer references, and they are all clickable if you have the landing page live on your screen. You can use international repositories, also a list. and you can participate in global projects, also interesting to see. Eh? So I recommend to browse further in this landing page and go on with incorporating the SDGs in your work.